So good morning, all of you. Welcome back once again. We are here with the new topic, which is Production Link Subsidy Scheme, which is launched very recently by Government of India. And this is the content video. And after the content, this is also structured in the form you can answer in the mains examination. So this is very much suitable for this 2020 mains examination. And this will also be suitable for 2021 UPSC examination. So let's begin. So starting with production linked incentive scheme. So what we are going to cover? We are going to cover what is the news. See, we will be very brief in discussing this session, and I don't want to elongate this. So I will be giving you a flash of the news and then context for why this production linked incentive scheme has been brought, and the features of the scheme, eligibility of companies to get this to get the benefit of this scheme, significance, and a suitable conclusion will be given. So this news can be used as introduction. See, this is a very from Indian Express, it has been taken. Cabinet approves production linked incentive scheme worth 1.46 lakhs crores for 10 sectors. So that's the news. And the scheme will make Indian manufacturers catch up the world, which will be very useful for the mains examination to make Indian manufacturers globally competitive, attracting investment and enhancing exports. So you should catch up these words. These keywords should be written, will give you a better impression in answer writing. So cabinet approved this production linked incentive scheme in 10 key sectors. Here, in for prelims point of view, it is there that advanced chemistry cell battery will be implemented by Niti Aayog and Department of Heavy Industries. So which is implementing for products that is given here, then that can be asked as a question separately in prelims. So electronics and technology products, Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. For automobiles and auto components, Department of Heavy Industries will be there. For pharmaceutical drugs, this will be by Department of Pharmaceuticals under Ministry of Chemical Fertilizer. Telecom and networking products will be under Department of Telecom. There are certain allotments has been done. For textile products, Ministry of Textile will be there. Food products, Ministry of Food Processing Industry. High efficiency solar photovoltaic modules, this is Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. White goods, what are these white goods? White goods, ACs and ampere related products, LED related products, or any electricity related products will be in the white goods industry, will be Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. And the specialty steel will be under Ministry of Steel. So these are the financial outlay for all these sectors under the ministries. Total is around, you can see 1.46 lakhs crore. So this is also proposed for around 50,000 crore, and that is mobile manufacturing and specified electronics components under MITI. And under Department of Pharmaceutical, critical key starting material or drug intermediaries are for promote development of active pharmaceutical ingredients, because we have seen that in Corona time when the whole world was in lockdown phase. So what happened? India faced a severe crisis of active pharmaceutical ingredients, and because of which we had our pharmaceutical prices have also increased. So to develop self-reliance, we are doing that. So manufacturing of medical devices under Department of Pharmaceutical. So let's talk about the context. What is the context? See, this question, this scheme can be used in the question related to industry. This can industry in paper number 3, GS paper number 3. And this scheme can be used in the questions with respect to Make in India. In geopolitics also, you can use this scheme very wisely in making India import सेल्फ रिलायंट है ना, और दिस कैन बी यूजफुल फॉर इम्पोर्ट सब्स्टिट्यूशन, दिस कैन बी यूजफुल फॉर मेकिंग ए ब्रांड, न्यू ब्रांड विच इज मेड इन इंडिया ब्रांड. लाइक वी हैव प्रेजेंटली मोस्ट ऑफ द अप्लायंसेज एंड गुड्स विच वी आर सीइंग नाउ इज मेड इन चाइना, है ना. दिस सिंगल स्कीम कैन बी वेरी मच बेनिफिशियल टू मेकिंग इंडिया सेल्फ रिलायंट एंड टू प्रमोट ए ब्रांड मेड इन इंडिया. So Make in India is a manufacturing hub. To make India a manufacturing hub, the government recently announced PLI scheme for mobile phones, pharma products and medical equipment sectors. It proposes a financial incentive to boost domestic manufacturing and attract large investments in electronics value chain. So that's what the idea is. This will not just increase the investment, this will also enhance technology, this will help domestic manufacturers grow. So the problem with our economy is that we directly moved from agricultural sector to service sector. Ideally what would have been happened that agriculture sector, we should have moved from agriculture sector to industry sector and then service sector. This is why China is leading. China has supplied, added its additional agricultural laborers to industry, and India, when it liberalized, it was developed in the form of services. So this is where we are lagging with respect to China. So let's see the features of the scheme. It aims to give companies incentives. So how these incentives will be given? Incremental sales from the product manufacturing in domestic units. So what is this incremental sales? Incremental sales kya hota hai? So if I say about the incremental sales, there will be a base year, and with respect to that base year, suppose in this base year 10 units are being produced, and in next year it is 20 units are being produced. So this 10 units, which is the difference, will be the incremental sale. And in this incremental sale, the incentive will be given. So apart from inviting foreign companies to set up shop in India, the scheme also aims to encourage local companies to set up and expand existing manufacturing units. The scheme shall extend an incentive. How much incentive has to be given? 4% to 6% on incremental sales over the base year. I told you about the base year. Of goods manufactured in India and covered under targeted schemes to eligible companies for a period of 5 years, with financial years 2019-20 considered as the base year. So which one is the base year? From which incremental sale will be calculated? That is 2019-2020 for calculation of incentives. So this is 4 to 6% incentive on the base year 2019-20, right? So this is implemented through, for implementation of such a vast scheme, there is a project management agency. This is a kind of single window system, which will be single window agency, you can say, which will be doing everything to implement this scheme. So this scheme has rolled out for mobile and allied equipment, as well as pharmaceutical ingredients and medical devices manufacturing. So you can just see eligibility. So its eligibility will be all electronic manufacturing companies which are either in India or have registered unit in India will be eligible to apply under this scheme. Any company which is registered under Companies Act in India will be eligible to get to subsidy under this scheme. These companies can either create a new unit or seek incentives for their existing units. So that means the existing units can also get the incentive, or they can either create new units for getting the incentive for one or more locations in India. Not necessarily that it has to be getting the incentive in one location, it can get incentive at multiple locations also. So a window has also been kept open for new sectors to be included in this PLI scheme after acquiring a fresh approval from the cabinet, right? So that's the idea. So if we discuss about the significance, what is the significance of this scheme? So there are multiple significance. I am giving you the three basic structure to write about the significance. For employment purpose, it is very significant scheme because it will boost skill, it will create additional employment, it will encourage Atmanirbhar Bharat, and with increased employment, it will ensure per capita income and it will help in building capacity. For export, it will bridge Gulf. It can help in dealing with the BOP crisis, and it can help in India in integrating with global supply chain. So the Made in India brand will be promoted. The Chinese threat, because of it is Chinese, India will be more competitive with respect to China. India can see the new markets, and it can utilize its product in the new markets like Brazil, like the smaller countries of Southeast Asia. So level playing field for Indian manufactured products with the branding like Made in India. So in exchange, when Indian products will be exported, in return Indian companies will receive some forex, which will be coming to India. So India will receive forex. It will help in building forex base. It will help in increasing our GDP. It will help in boosting GDP per capita income. And it will help in also promoting PPP model, purchasing power, public-private partnership model. And this will help in increasing the technological transfer. So technological transfer will also be improved with respect to this scheme, if this scheme is implemented well. So this is how you will have to write the significance. In the question which I am giving you, you try to bring out some innovation, because the freshness in your answer will attract more marks. So if you bring certain suitable innovation, then definitely you are going to get marks. So if we see about the conclusion for this topic, you can have a very optimistic conclusion regarding this topic. So you can see that India can export her Made in India branded goods to new and emerging markets. You can also write like Brazil and Southeast Asia, and it can provide boost for the schemes like Atmanirbhar Bharat, schemes like Make in India. So this is that is how you are showing that this scheme is so important that not just it will promote export, but it will also improve the domestic capabilities, and it can, so that is why with all these it can help in making India the global leader. So this is how you'll have to write the conclusion if you are writing any answer. So with this, we'll be seeing the prelims question. Which of the following industry has been matched correctly? You just see in the question, and I will be discussing in the evening, in discussion video, in follow-up video. Mains practice question: discuss production linked incentive scheme in context of Atmanirbhar Bharat. That's a very simple question, a very important question. So please write this question. Share if you write well, then I will be surely be giving you review on that. Please write and submit it on our application and Telegram channel. So okay, see you all. All the best.